won the wild card comp, choosing not to use it. Cool.
Mm-hmm.
So now we can get back to business. I still am trying to get an idea for what I want to do. So I think after the individual meetings, then I'll have more of a clear cut idea of what I feel like I need to do. So I'll let you do some talking. What you got?
Okay, so right now, regardless whatever you decide to do,
mm-hmm.
you have radical, mm-hmm. so you have all the votes in the House.
Okay.
You have seven.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone else, especially whoever to go up, it's they go home.
Okay.
Whoever your target is. What I do know is that Kylan does believe, and I think everyone else does too, that Slaughterhouse is still in effect.
Okay.
Which protects us
mm-hmm.
with Big D. But Big D has also been against the vote twice.
Okay.
So I don't really know
where he lies.
Where his vote would lie.
Uh-huh.
If it came to something, because he's been doing it twice
uh-huh.
already. So the fact is that like whatever you decide to do, you have the majority of the votes regardless.
Okay.
So whoever your target is, if they don't win the veto, they go home
uh-huh.
with my team, your team.
Agreed.
Other than that, it's like I said, Slaughterhouse is still in effect.
Mm-hmm.
I don't see that lasting very long.
Yeah.
As far as just because.
Well, truthfully, I think if we gave people a reason to think that it's really dismantled,
mm-hmm.
even if, obviously, one, if it is going to be dismantled, then it is what it is. But two, if it was still to kind of be cohesive, especially Big D's mm-hmm. eyes, to know that. Like, to give maybe the illusion to the rest of the House that it's broken.
Yeah.
But to us, we still know that things are exactly. good. I think that could be beneficial.
Powerful.
Long term.
Yeah.
I think that's my... Let me ask you...
Yeah, yeah.
I think you brought this up to me before, just looking at kind of the history of the eviction. So, like, Travis has gone home.
Mm-hmm.
Frenchie has gone home.
Mm-hmm.
How do you feel about that?
So... As far as Travis...
Not like Travis and Frenchie going on. I'm saying from a numbers perspective, how do you feel about that?
To be honest, man, it puts the narrative and the odds in mm-hmm. favor of, let's just say, all the women go rogue.
Mm-hmm.
It's a tough situation. That's why the narrative being the all-girl alliance that was brewing, or still is,
okay.
was powerful mm-hmm. because we had a logical reason.
Uh-huh.
To make some type of move, which would be towards the females.
Do you feel like it's still brewing?
Honestly, this is the thing. It's like Frenchie was running it.
Uh-huh.
I don't know if you knew that.
Uh-huh.
His silence was broken after
yeah.
Hannah mm-hmm. told me that she was approached by it.